हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल इलेक्ट्रिकल टेक्नोलॉजी एंड इंडस्ट्रियल प्रैक्टिस। सो टुडे यू कैन सी दैट आवर टॉपिक इज वोल्टेज डिपेंडेंट ओवर करंट रिले। सो दिस इज बेसिकली ए जेनरेटर प्रोटेक्शन, ओके। एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग दैट व्हाई नॉर्मल ओवर करंट रिले प्रोटेक्शन इज नॉट सफिशियंट फॉर जेनरेटर एंड व्हाई वी नीड ए वोल्टेज डिपेंडेंट पैरामीटर, ओके। सो लेट्स बिगिन द वीडियो। Larger generator in larger generator or smaller generator also plain overcurrent protection is difficult because in case of generator load current is very high and sometimes it is significantly comparable with the fault current, steady state fault current, and it may be higher than steady state fault current. So it may sound absurd, but it happens that the load current, that is I full load current, is greater than I short circuit current under steady state. Okay, this is steady state. I'm writing it as SS, steady state short circuit current. It may be higher. So in that case, if you have to select a relay pickup, then you have to keep the relay pickup higher than full load current but lower than short circuit current, which is not possible. Suppose your full load current is 300 ampere and your short circuit current, steady state current is 150 ampere in any case, then you have to select something which is higher than 300 but lower than 150, which is not possible practically. It is a fallacy. So to encounter this, we have to introduce a voltage dependent parameter. Okay, voltage parameters is introduced. So now we will see that why this kind of characteristics appears in generator. Okay. If we see the generator characteristics of short circuit, generator short circuit characteristics, then we will see that the generator short circuit current looks something like this. It has an envelope with decaying nature. So let me draw the envelope. Say this is the envelope of the short circuit current. Okay. This is without any DC component. That is symmetrical short circuit current. So here the generator fault current looks something like this. Okay. So from sub-transient state, transient state, this is the steady state condition. Okay, so this is time and this is magnitude. This is the value of the short circuit current. Now there the DC component is coming. DC component will mix, which is a decaying nature. So this is time and this is current I. This is the DC component. So when this DC will mix up with this component, when the DC will add up with this, the characteristics will look something like this. So first let me draw the envelope. So the envelope will further go up and this part will be something like this. Okay. So the characteristics will be this kind of. So here the curve will be running. This is a sinusoidal curve. So this is the basically a generator fault current when the fault happens at generator terminal. So you can see that there is a huge variation of the fault current also. Without the DC, the generator itself has a variation of fault current. So that is why conventional overcurrent protection is not adequate to give a successful operation, a successful generator protection. So that is why voltage dependent overcurrent protections are introduced. Now there are two types of voltage dependent overcurrent relay. Number one is voltage controlled overcurrent relay, and number two is voltage restrained overcurrent relay, So first let us check the characteristics of voltage controlled overcurrent relay. Okay. So first let me draw the characteristics of the relay. Okay. Pickup characteristics of the relay. So this is y axis and this is x axis. Along x axis there will be voltage and along y axis there is pickup current. This I is the pickup current. Okay. So this is say a set voltage point Vs. Okay. So up to this point there will be a certain value of current pickup. So this is say Is, I greater than. Okay. And below this there will be another current pickup. This is Ki, greater than. Okay. So you will see that the characteristics is such that when the generator terminal voltage is above the set voltage, that is greater than VS, the pickup current is higher, I greater than or the pickup current is higher. And when the voltage is lower than VS, then the pickup current has been reduced. Okay. So that is the basic control of the voltage. So when there is fault happened, suppose a fault has happened away from the generator, so the voltage at generator terminal will not fall. So this will simply act as a overcurrent, act as an overload fault. Okay. So there the pickup current will be higher. And since the generator voltage has not fault, so the pickup current will be higher. But in case the voltage fault has happened near to the generator, then the generator terminal voltage will fall. It may come below VS. Okay. So in that case, the pickup current will be reduced. It will be KI. Okay. So this will further trigger the relay to operate first. So this is voltage controlled overcurrent relay. Now we will see the characteristics of voltage restrained overcurrent relay. Okay. So voltage restrained overcurrent relay. Now in voltage restrained overcurrent relay, there are two settings of voltage. One is VS1 and another is VS2. Say this is V and this is pickup current I. So here there will be one voltage set point VS1 and the another voltage set point VS2. So up to this, the current pickup will be I greater than say, and up to this point, the current setup will be KI greater than. So this is KI pickup, and from this point VS1 to VS2, this will be inclined. There will be a slope. Unless this is an instantaneous rise, there is a slope rise. So this characteristics is introduced to just to give a IDMT characteristic. So more the voltage has fallen, the early the relay will pick up. Okay, so this is the two types of voltage controlled overcurrent relay, voltage controlled, I'm sorry, voltage dependent overcurrent relay, the voltage controlled overcurrent relay and voltage restrained overcurrent relay. In the next video, I will show a typical example by which you will be clear that how this relay operates. So I hope you have enjoyed the operating principle of the relay and basic selection criteria of the relay. If you enjoyed, please like, share, comment, and subscribe to our channel. And please hit the bell icon to get the latest notifications of our video. Thank you very much for watching this video.